press this, and you can see this, hear this, taste this, and experience this. Press the green button at Ireland.com.
Eurogold is driven by being the best civil engineering contractor in the Northwest, ensuring its clients are given the highest level of service that they deserve. Eurogold work in a wide range of industry sectors, including house building, highways, commercial and industrial build.
Lolavita is an award-winning, independently run Italian restaurant. Located on Rose Lane in the heart of Liverpool, real Italian-style dishes, using the best ingredients, skillfully prepared by our chefs. Come and try our serious Italian experience.
The Warrington Irish Club. Friendly and welcoming club keeping the Irish culture alive. We have Irish and country music every Saturday night, tribute nights, race nights, charity nights and karaoke. All live sports are shown on big screens. We have snooker, dominoes and crown green bowling teams along with arts and craft. Pop in for a friendly welcome and book your event at the Warrington Irish Club. Give Frank a call on 01925 243 363.
Mulligan's Funeral and Monumental Services are a family-owned funeral service first established by the late Brian Mulligan in 1996. We provide funeral homes in Gorton, Manchester and Redditch, Stockport, and we pride ourselves on giving a friendly and professional service to all the families who use our service. Contact us on 0161 432 0809.
Press this, and you can see this, hear this, taste this, and experience this. Press the green button at Ireland.com.
Hello and welcome to the show. This week we're coming to you from London for the Galway Association Dinner Dance. And I've been joined by Barbara Edwardson, the treasurer of the association. Barbara, how are you going on?
Good, Martin. Now, very good. Thank you very much. We're here celebrating 66 years of the Galway Association of London. We're very lucky. We've Martin Ruddy and his band here tonight who will get everyone up on the dance floor. We've been joined by Jack Glynn, who is the Young Footballer of the Year, and we're delighted to have him. And we have Finbar Burke as our Galway Man of the Year. We're really lucky.
Now, of course, you've not had a dinner dance for the last few years.
No, COVID now put a stop to all of that, but it's great to have everybody back, and it's lovely to see everybody out again.
Absolutely, and of course, we're in for a fantastic meal.
Oh, absolutely. We love the Clayton. Absolutely. I'm sure everybody will have a great night.
Come on then, let's go inside and see what's happening.
For you stole through Valiant's call, so the young might see the morn. Now the prison ship lies waiting in the bay.
Small
dreamers,
I am
a
dreamer,
our love is on the
Reverend Father, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Galway Dinner Dance in the Clayton Hotel.
Seamus, 66 years of the Galway Association, fantastic.
Brilliant. And it's such a good, lovely location tonight, and a lot of nice people here tonight.
We all remember Sean Burke and we all miss him so much.
Yeah, Sean Burke was the anchor of this association, and we're just pulling it along, and Bob is the anchor now, and we're all giving a hand all the way along. But Sean Burke was the matriarch of this society.
Our Galway Man of the Year, Finbar Burke.
Finbar, many congratulations on being honoured by coming the Galway Person of the Year.
Thank you very much, Martin.
Great to see you here, of course, Finbar, and of course, a lot of your friends are here tonight.
Oh yeah, we've got a lot of family, friends, we've got people over from Ireland. Yeah, it's been a great night. First time in the Clayton Chiswick. Very good facility as well.
Now, you've been involved with the Galway Association for a long time.
Since the early 70s, Martin. Yeah, 50 years nearly now, yeah.
And how long did you serve as chairman?
Oh, 25 years or so. Something in that region.
You stayed a long time and you've done a lot of work in them times, Finbar.
Well, that seemed to be the sort of, it was quite a very settled organisation for many years, you know. But then we start getting old and we try to recruit young people, and we're glad to say we have a very good young committee, good mixture, good young and some of our old ones still around. But it's going very well and it looks like we have a good future.
But of course you put in a lot of work through down the years, you and Bobby Burke and lots more people.
And the late Sean, you know, we mustn't forget Sean Burke, you know. Sean was the great anchor of all things Galway, whether it was GA, horse racing, social functions, whatever. Sean Burke was a great organiser, great contact.
Now, I know it means a lot to you to be Galway Person of the Year this year, and sadly, earlier on this year, you lost your lovely wife, Nora.
That's a fact, yeah, we had a very tough time. She succumbed to Alzheimer's on the 24th of January this year after a hard battle, especially during the COVID period when it was difficult to see doctors and hospital appointments were non-existent. All telephone stuff, which was heartbreaking for somebody with such a chronic illness. But she died in Ireland. We went over for a break after the COVID restrictions were lifted, and she got very sick there and sadly passed away in the hospice in St. Bridget's in the Curra. So my granddaughter Amelia, who's with us here tonight, who was 16 at the time, she actually competed in a 10K run for the hospice, and she'll be presenting a cheque for a couple of £1,000 the next few weeks to St. Bridget's Hospice in the Curra for the wonderful treatment they gave her granny.
But of course you and Nora, your wife, done a lot of things together down the years, and you had so many pubs around London.
Oh, we had 54 years in the pub trade, Martin. We both management and tenants, leaseholders. Oh, we ran several pubs in the Greater London area, City, West End, and mainly West London towards the end of our time. That was 20 years in Hampton Hill, in the windmill Hampton Hill. All very popular, very successful. And, you know, we had a great time.
Sean, a great night for the Galway Association.
Absolutely, yeah. Delighted to be here representing the embassy tonight. Finbar Burke and the Burke family are famous, synonymous with South Galway, so it was great to honour one of our local people.
Sean Finbar, well deserved.
I'm the Agriculture and Fisheries Councillor at the embassy. My role here is very much to just ensure that we develop and cultivate very good relationships with the UK.
It's a very challenging job at this moment in time.
Absolutely. I mean, with the economy, with the cost of living crisis, among other things, it's important that we work hard to work together in a collaborative way. I've been in London about 15 months at this stage. I'll be at least 3 years here. And possibly more, but we'll see.
Only for these three women, there would be no Galway Association. But please, let's give you a big round of applause. The amount of work they do is unreal.
Almighty ever-living God, we ask that you bless this great Galway Association. We ask that you bless the great county of Galway. an ahar as in vic as in spirit name. Amen.
Many congratulations, Father. I believe you're newly ordained.
Yeah, just I was ordained on the 25th of June, just earlier this year, in St. Peter and St. Paul Church in Ilford, in Essex.
Many congratulations to you. And how are you finding things since you were ordained?
Just settling into it now at the moment and getting used to various different things, but kept busy now at the moment.
Well, that's good. And I know that you've been up in Manchester as well, doing a few funerals and different things for relatives.
At the moment, yeah, travelling the country now. I think it's a novelty having an Irish priest at the moment, so I'm getting plenty of funerals and baptisms.
Well, I was just going to say to you that, you know, you're one of a few that we've not got many Irish priests now.
Very little now at the moment, but what we have now is quality. I was born in Loughrea in County Galway, and then I spent most of my time there until 2008. I moved to the United Kingdom as a teacher, and I worked my way up in the school, and I left as deputy head, and I realised then God was calling me to do something else with my life. I spent 6 years in a seminary in London, and I'm now a happily ordained priest now.
What inspired you to leave teaching and, you know, become a priest?
I think there was always kind of something missing from my life. I was never fully happy in my job or in my relationships or career, so I decided I needed to try something else, and I said I'd try this and see what happened, and now I'm very happy at the moment. I've got three older brothers and one younger sister, and both my parents are also back in Loughrea. Over the last year, I've been working with the Irish Chaplaincy in London, so I've seen many elderly Irish people who've come across the 1950s, 60s, and it's been just a chance to hear their stories. And the Galway Association really supports those people.
So how are you settling here in London?
Yeah, I'm getting well used to it now at this stage, and I think my accent has got stronger. My Irish accent and my identity, Irish accent and identity, still very important to me. So hello to my whole family, the Wade family in Loughrea, and I'll see you after the Christmas.
Bobby, great to see you again. Of course, it's a special night here tonight, celebrating 66 years of the Galway Association.
Yeah, it's a fantastic night. We had a lovely crowd, the food was fantastic, and, you know, the band is in there now and people are really enjoying themselves.
Listen, you've always got happy campers when the meal is good.
But yes, that sets the whole night up, you know, and tonight was exceptional tonight. I never seen tin plates at my table empty. Completely. It was like when we were kids, we used to nearly lick the place.
Of course, Matty, looking back over the years, 66 years, so much memories, so many good times.
Great memories. Met lovely people from the day I joined the Galway Association, which is a long time ago.
It's great to see that you've got a lot of young people involved now.
Absolutely. They are the people in the future, aren't they? You know, it was so old codgers this time we were going to bed early.
Now, you've got a great array of cups in there tonight.
Oh, yeah, St. Gabriel's, my team.
I met Matty at an All-Ireland in Dublin and the hurling, and they were really going well. And we came out at half-time and Matty said, that is great stuff now. He said, besides that stuff you're playing down in Montpellier. And I said to Matty, I have a Connacht final middle playing hurling. And I said, you haven't got one. And he thought I never played hurling, but I have a Connacht final middle playing hurling and two playing football. What has he got?
Yeah. Well, that's it, a teacup.
He could have bought them, you know. They were selling them cheap in my life that time.
And it's great that you're giving us such support, Martin, yourself and Annette. It's fantastic that you come down every year and give us a big build up.
And Matty, of course, the golf day is coming up. You better get shaping up.
Yeah. I have the golf sticks in the kitchen, just practicing the garden for it.
Well, look at the hurling have come out.
Well, look at, I'm going to take these two boys out now, one for a hurling match and the other one for a golfing game, and we're going to take a little break and we'll see you in a few minutes.
Press this, and you can see this, hear this, taste this. And experience this. Press the green button at Ireland.com.
Eurogold is driven by being the best civil engineering contractor in the Northwest, ensuring its clients are given the highest level of service that they deserve. Eurogold work in a wide range of industry sectors, including house building, highways, commercial and industrial build.
Lolavita is an award-winning, independently run Italian restaurant. Located on Rose Lane in the heart of Liverpool, real Italian-style dishes, using the best ingredients, skillfully prepared by our chefs. Come and try our serious Italian experience.
The Warrington Irish Club. Friendly and welcoming club keeping the Irish culture alive. We have Irish and country music every Saturday night, tribute nights, race nights, charity nights and karaoke. All live sports are shown on big screens. We have snooker, dominoes and crown green bowling teams along with arts and craft. Pop in for a friendly welcome and book your event at the Warrington Irish Club. Give Frank a call on 01925 243 363.
Mulligan's Funeral and Monumental Services are a family-owned funeral service, first established by the late Brian Mulligan in 1996. We provide funeral homes in Gorton, Manchester and Redditch, Stockport, and we pride ourselves on giving a friendly and professional service to all the families who use our service. Contact us on 0161 432 0809.
Press this, and you can see this, hear this, taste this, and experience this. Press the green button at Ireland.com.
Welcome back. This week we're coming to you from the Clayton Hotel in London, celebrating 66 years of the Galway Association. It's always a great night. Now I'm going in to see how they're all shaping up. Bobby, I know that it's been a busy year for you as well and for your son, because of course you opened a pub here in London.
Yeah, we opened about 6 months ago and it's absolutely flying at the moment, and we're more than pleased. And Sean, my youngest son, he seems to be a natural, and I hope he keeps going that way. If he keeps going that way, he will do very well.
Yeah. And of course it's called Burke's Warehouse. Where did you get the name from?
Well, up in that area there, there's most of the pubs up there closed. And when I got the pub designed by a fella called Fintan MacDonald in Northern Ireland, it's the way he designed it. It didn't look like a normal pub. And up that area there, it needed a name like that. So we were thinking, and someone came up with the idea of Burke's Warehouse, and we thought, that's a great idea. And it really is a good idea, and it's going well.
It's difficult for all businesses at the moment.
It is, yeah. Some people are really struggling. But when we opened first, it was quite slow because the pub had been closed for 2 years and there was no regulars. When you have no regulars coming into a pub, you know, it's tough. But now it's really picked up and things are good.
Of course, you're so much involved yourself, Seamus, with the association here between the dinner dance night and, of course, the golf days. They're a big success for you.
They're massive. That's where we raise all our money from. We don't get much money out of these nights now, but we get a lot of money out of the golf day and the fundraising we do. We do it for Reach Out and helping people that are, you know, that are on hard times and stuff like that. And I'm sure this year is going to be no exception with the way bills are and stuff is this year. I'm sure people will need a lot more help.
Now, you've got a lot of relatives and friends and family here tonight, and we saw you all lining up there for a lovely photograph.
That's right, yeah. My wife is here, my brother-in-law, my son, his girlfriend who's from Germany. No connection with Galway at all. They're getting married next year, and that's in Dingle. And you might come to Dingle to do the gig.
Well, if it's as good as the Galway Association do tonight, we might chance it.
It'll be better.
Of course, it's great to see that you've got a Galway footballer here, Jack Glynn, tonight.
Jack Glynn, we have a cornerback. He has a runners-up medal, but he said he'll be here next year with a winner's medal. Yeah.
And he's also GAA Player of the Year.
He's GAA Young Player of the Year in the whole of Ireland. Yeah. What a tribute. And he could have come yesterday, but he wouldn't come yesterday because there was training last night in Galway. And he got up at 4 o'clock this morning and got on the flight this morning to come here.
Many congratulations, of course, on being Young Player of the Year this year, and also, of course, winning the Under 20 All Ireland a couple of years back.
Yeah, look, I suppose it's a tremendous honour for myself and my family. I know it means an awful lot to my father personally, but for my club, Clare Galway, that's where I come from. They're my roots, and it's, you know, from working with the coaches from underage all the way up. That I've been able to have the ability to compete and trial out for Galway, and luckily enough, Bork saw something in me, and I am, I suppose, where I got to today, just under their guidance and their management.
It's a great pleasure to be here with you tonight to say a few words about the current state of play with Galway GAA. I first came to this great city of London in 1975 as a young 17-year-old. At the time, there were little or no summer jobs for students back home in Ireland, and I was fortunate to get a job with my cousin Finbar Burke in his pub in the West End. I played hurling with St. Gabriel's Club, and it was great to win the intermediate hurling title that year with them. I was the youngest in the team managed by the great Ambrose Gordon. Some of my teammates are here tonight. I met Carol Burke early on, Brindy Bryan, Pori Coolan, Mick Nevin, to name but a few. It is a great honour for me to return to London so many years later as Treasurer of Galway County Board.
Michael, of course, a very successful year for Galway GAA.
Very successful both on the field and off the field. So we were beaten in an Ireland hurling semi-final by the eventual winners, and we were beaten in an Ireland football final by Kerry, the Ireland champions. So a very, very close call on both situations. We could easily have won both.
I heard you speaking in there tonight to all the guests, and of course talking about the Galway County Board and how much progress it's made over the last few years.
There's been a complete transformation over the last 5 years. We've put controls in place. It's a different Galway now, and we've reduced debt dramatically.
I believe that you're renaming Tuam Stadium. Tell me a little bit about that.
No, we're not, say, renaming Pier Stadium, but we're very close to a situation where we're selling the naming rights. It will be a sponsor, but it'll still be called Pier Stadium. We wouldn't dream about deleting Piers from Pier Stadium. No, that would not be in the agenda at all. It would be an honest comment to make that we are the busiest GAA county in Ireland. We're number one jewel county, as the results show this year. And going forward, we compete in the most competitions. And I would say, even in the last week, the new sponsorship deal that we have with Supermax is the second largest ever, completed in Ireland. Second largest ever sponsorship deal for the next 5 years. It's a business. It's a 5 million business. And you, as I said, you cannot spend money if you don't make it. And we have the ability to make money now. We're a good brand.
Of course, you made huge strides this year to go out with senior football team. How much dedication, time and training goes into that?
I suppose Parker says that like when we're in Galway, it's our number one priority, outside family, of course, but, and he's right as well. Everyone buys into it. I suppose when you have a collective coming together, there's not much that can go wrong. Everyone buys into the same thing, has the same vision. Look, you're halfway there already, Sean. So, yeah, I was delighted to get where we were, but obviously disappointed to not get the final result.
What's it like to walk out on Crow Park on All-Ireland Day and represent Galway?
Well, it was a surreal experience for me personally, because obviously I would have been there back in 2017 and 18 watching the hurlers, or back when my old teacher, Sir Donald, was teaching, back when he was walking out playing in All-Ireland final. So it was crazy, but something I didn't like get to my head either. Same time, I was just kind of cool about it, and just take it as it was. Like when you're in that that buzz and that excitement, you don't really hear too much. It's more so just a buzz, and you just get on with it and you do your job. So, yeah.
I was always involved in sport. You know, Galway GA, London GA. I was lifelong sort of participant and member of the Gables Hurling Club here, and you know they've been very successful over the years. Then we're very involved with Galway GA. You know, there's a lot of family connections there. You know, we know team players. We know, you know, it's part of our life. And I'm also involved in the rugby football. You know, I was heavily involved in London Irish for many years. You know, both in the children's and the adult rugby in the amateur days, not as a professional. Amateurs, Martin.
Well, we know that your Paul played rugby as well at a very high standard.
Well, he actually capped for Ireland in 95. He played in the 95 World Cup. You know, so that was a huge achievement, great honour for the family, great honour for the club.
And of course, Finbar, you've got some great music here tonight.
Well, we have Martin Ruddy, Martin Mayo man. You know, Martin has been in the London circuit, I suppose, for 25 years at least. It wouldn't be his first time playing in a Galway function. No.
All enjoyed it tonight, Finbar. It's been a lovely, lovely night here with the Galway Association. And look, I know it's been a special night for you, and I hope you enjoyed it too.
It's always special when your own people honour you for bits of work you've done or bits of good deeds we've done for people down through the years. And I'm thrilled actually to be the recipient.
Well done.
Yeah.
Well done. Well, look, that brings us to the end of the show for this week. And what better way could we finish it but with the Galway Person of the Year, Finbar Burke. Well done, Finbar. Congratulations.
Thank
and from me and Finbar, take good care.
Thank you very much, Jeanette, and thank you, Martin.
Press the green button at Ireland.com.